able to be fruitful at the workplace? Number one, and maybe for the sake of those that were not, let's read Matthew chapter 7 and verse 20. Matthew chapter 7, verse 20. God wants us to be fruitful. That is what we are saying. Mungu anataka tukue na mazao. Mungu anataka tuwe na mazao. Biblia inasema ya kwamba Yesu akiongea anasema wherefore by their fruits you shall know them. Ukitaka kujua watoto wa Mungu, ukitaka kujua wa Kristo, angalia vile wanazaa matunda. Ukiona mtu anazaa matunda sana, huyo ni Mkristo, kwa sababu wa Kristo wanastahili kuzaa matunda. Christians are supposed to bear good fruits. We are talking about good fruits, the fruits of the kingdom. The fruits of the kingdom. They are in Galatians chapter 5 from verse 22. The fruits of the Spirit. The fruits of the Spirit. They are listed there. So you see, a Christian being able to bear such fruits, then that one is indeed a Christian. So how do you become fruitful at the workplace? Because we said, if you are not fruitful at the place of work, you will struggle to bear fruits everywhere else. If you are not fruitful at the workplace, then anywhere else you go, you will struggle. Kama unasumbuanaga kazini, ata kanisani utasumbuana, ata nyumbani utasumbuana, mahali popote utaenda, wewe utakuwa tu ni sumbua. Kama hauwezi ukazaa matunda mazuri kazini, ata kanisani hautaweza kuzaa matunda mazuri. Mimi nasema kitu ambacho nimekiona, kwa sababu nimekuwa mchungaji kwa muda kiasi, hata kama sio muda mrefu, lakini muda kiasi nimekuwa mchungaji. Kuanzia 2009 nimekuwa mchungaji, from 2009 hadi wa leo, hizo ni miaka zaidi ya 10 nimekuwa mchungaji. Kwa hivyo ninaweza nikakwambia watu ambao ni wazuri kazini, utapata kwamba ni wazuri nyumbani, utapata kwamba ni wazuri kwa wazazi, utapata ni wazuri kwa mume wao, utapata ni wazuri hata kanisani, utapata wao ni wazuri kila mahali. Ninaomba kwamba Mungu atakupatia roho ya uzuri kuanzia leo katika jina la Yesu. How do you become fruitful at work? Number one, do not allow your work to disconnect you from Jesus. That is number one. Do not allow your work to disconnect you from Jesus. John chapter 15 verse 4 to 5. Give us from NIV. The only way you will continue to bear fruits is when you remain connected to Jesus. When you remain connected to Jesus, that is the only way you can bear good fruits. A pastor who is not connected to Jesus cannot bear good fruits. A minister that is not connected to Jesus cannot bear good fruits. A politician who is not connected to Jesus cannot be a good politician. A mother that has deserted Jesus, a father that has rebelled from Jesus, cannot become a good parent. A worker who is not connected to Jesus, a worker that is drinking right now beer instead of going to church, that one cannot be a good worker. A worker who, instead of going to church, they went traveling home, they went looking for friends, they went visiting people, cannot be a good and faithful worker. When you're looking for workers to employ, go to church and find people that are humble, people that are good to God, people that pay their tithes, people that are following God, people who pray, people who love God, people who read books. Those are people that are going to become good workers, people that are obedient, people that are humble. Those are the people you can employ and they will not frustrate you. Remain in me and I will remain in you. No branch can bear fruit by itself. It has to be connected. It must remain in me, in the vine. Neither can you bear fruits unless you remain in me. You cannot become good unless you're connected to Jesus. You don't have the capacity, the capability to become good unless you are connected to Jesus. You have to be connected to Jesus for you to start bearing good fruits. Somebody say, I will connect myself. Somebody say, I will remain in Christ. Say again, I will remain in Jesus. The Bible says in the book of Romans chapter 8 and verse 1, there is therefore now no condemnation. There is therefore now no condemnation to them that are in Christ. Anybody that in Christ, you will not find them being condemned. Therefore, there is now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Any person that remains in Christ, there will be no way for you to condemn them. They will always be good. They tried to condemn Joseph, and Joseph was innocent. They tried to, you know, to condemn Daniel, but Daniel was found to be faultless and blemish, and without any blemish and without any sin. When they come accusing you, are they always right? I pray that God will give you the ability to bear good fruits in the name of Jesus. So number one, connect yourself to Jesus. That is, do not allow your work to disconnect you from Jesus. Fanya kazi kwa bidii. I told you in the morning, you have to work hard and you have to work well. But don't allow that work to remove you from Jesus. Because even if you continue working, you will never be able to bear fruits without the help of Jesus. Number two, find a man to show you the way. Find a man to show you the way. Find a man to show you the way. God designed man to be interdependent. God designed you and I to rely on each other. We have to rely on one another because the blessings of God comes from heaven to man and from man to another man. The blessings of God comes from heaven to man and from man to another man. We don't have everything. I can have the blessing that I got from heaven that I'm supposed to communicate to you, and you can have another blessing that I need, that will come from heaven to you and is supposed to be communicated to me. We have to rely on one another. We have to rely on one another. I can be your pastor and you can be my lecturer in the university. We have to rely with one another. We are created to be interdependent. Don't be an island of yourself. Don't be an island of yourself. Don't be a lone ranger. Don't be a lone ranger saying that you can do everything. Quoting those scriptures, the Bible also says, because there is no scripture that has no a mate. There is no scripture that is interpreted by itself. It has to be interpreted by another scripture. So the Bible says that two are better than one. And man, it is not good for the man to be alone. Look at a neighbor and tell them, God created you to work with someone. God created you to work with people. So the more you connect with people, the more you succeed. You cannot succeed alone. You cannot succeed alone. The more you connect with people, the more you succeed. Many people are stationary today in life and in career because they have no man to help them. They have no man to help them. They have no man to help them. I'm reminded by the Spirit of God of the man who stayed at the pool for 38 years. And the reason he stagnated for 38 years was because he lacked a man to help him into the pool. Maybe you are stagnating because you lack the right person, the right people to help you. In this life, there are people who are called destiny helpers, destiny connectors. They connect you to your destiny. They connect you to your destiny. Like Samuel was the destiny connector, destiny helper of King Saul. If it wasn't for Samuel, he wouldn't have gotten the throne. 1 Samuel chapter 10, verse 1 and 2, you can see that story. 1 Samuel chapter 9, verse 5 to 6, you will see that story there. Without Samuel, Saul would never have become a king of Israel. You need somebody in your life. You need people in your life. Acha kuangalia watu na manyira. Acha kuangalia watu na madharau. You need them. That one could be your miracle helper. That one could be your destiny helper. Look at your neighbor and tell them, don't joke with me. Hey, tell another neighbor, don't joke with me. Hallelujah. There are some people you employ and your business explodes and your business goes to the next level. There is somebody that comes into your life and you're blessed. The Bible says, he that findeth a wife findeth a good thing and he obtaineth favor with the Lord. Kama hangekuwa amepata huyo bibi, hangepata kibali kwa Mungu. Kuna watu wanakuja kwa maisha yako, wana connect hata binguni, wanafanya hata binguni ukumbukwe, wanafanya hata binguni Mungu achilie baraka katika maisha yako. Naomba Mungu akupatie watu kama hao. Naomba Mungu akupatie watu kama hao. Naomba Mungu akupatie destiny connectors, destiny helpers in the mighty name of Jesus. That is why vijana mko hapa, ukioa kuna mbibi unaweza pata, unlock maisha yako, unlock destiny yako. Ukue wewe hauwezi ukafika mahali Mungu alitaka ufike. Kwa hivyo be careful. There are some people you get in your life and they become your prison. They become your prison. I pray that God will help you to, you will help you to avoid such traps in your life. Hallelujah. There is somebody that can marry you and you will never go to heaven. There is somebody that can marry you and you will never succeed in life. Yet there are people that when they come to you, things begin to open up for you. Things begin to work for you. I'm sending such people in the spirit for you in the name of Jesus. I'm sending such people to you in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Lift up your hand and say, my Father, my God, open my eyes and give me wisdom. Open my eyes and give me discernment. Yes. Yes. Hallelujah. Young people that are here, I pray that God will give you the right people to marry you. And before you get married, find somebody who can advise you. Find somebody who can advise you. Number three, find something to do. This is how to become fruitful at the workplace. How to become fruitful at the workplace. Number three, find something to do. Don't be lazy. Find something you can do. The biggest enemy of fruitfulness is idleness. Somebody say idleness. The biggest enemy of fruitfulness in your business is not Satan. The biggest enemy of your greatness, your progress, your prosperity, your success in life is not the devil. The greatest enemy is idleness. Count the time you stay idle. That is your enemy. Measure the time you stay idle. That is your enemy. If somebody here is going to become rich, they will value time. They will value time. They will not sit down. They will not sit down and do nothing. I pray that you will defeat the spirit of idleness. I pray in the name of Jesus that in this church and in this congregation, anybody that is here, you will be able to defeat the spirit of idleness. You will defeat the spirit of idleness. You will defeat the spirit of idleness. Some of you are supposed to be very far, but you are too lazy. You are too lazy. You don't work. You don't wake up. You stay at home. You stay doing nothing. In church, some of you are supposed to be very far in terms of anointing, in terms of ministry. But you come to church and you sit down and you do nothing. Find something to do. Look at your neighbor and tell them, defeat the spirit of idleness. Hallelujah. Tell them I pray for you. Inua mkono wako juu, usifikishe kwa kichwa chake, weka tu hapo karibu na kichwa chake kama drone, kama helicopter, na umwambie na kuombea. Ninakuombea dugu. Ninakuombea dada. Ushinde roho ya uvivu. Ushinde roho ya kukaa chini. Katika jina la Yesu. Hiyo ndiyo shida kubwa tuko nayo hata kanisani. The reason why many people go to pastor and cry, pastor, I have not paid school fees, I have not paid house rent. It is because of sitting down and doing nothing. Wake up and go look for something to do. If you are not employed, wake up. Leave your house, go out and find something to do. In Kikuyu dialect, they say that mote oguagiro ya wehakuhe. The tree will always fall upon the person that is near. If you're not near, the tree will never fall on you. If you want the tree to fall on you, the tree of gold, the tree of opportunities, the tree of favor. If you want that tree to fall on you, wake up and begin to work. Wake up and begin to work. Lift up a hand and say, my Father, my God, today I receive the grace to work. I receive the grace to work. I receive the grace to work. Proverbs 19 verse 15. This is what the Bible says. Proverbs 19 and verse 15. This is what the Bible says. Give us from KJV. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Slothfulness. We are reading together because we are all in church. Slothfulness casteth into a deep sleep, and an idle soul shall suffer hunger. Give us from Good News. Give us from Good News. Let us read it from Good News. And see, we are not going to be rebuking you here. We will allow the Spirit of God and the Word of God to do the work. Hallelujah. Let us read together. One, two, go. Go ahead and be lazy. Sleep on, but you will go hungry. Look at a neighbor and tell them, continue. Mwambia jirani endelea. Mwambia endelea kulala. Endelea kulala tu. Umaskini unakuja. Umaskini utakuita. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Sema nimekataa kuwa masikini. Sema tena nimekataa kuwa masikini. Mimi si masikini. Hallelujah. Kama hautaki kuwa maskini, basi amka na uende kazi. Ninaomba neema ya kufanya kazi iwe juu yako katika jina la Yesu. Inua mkono wako uombe pamoja nami, sema, my Father, my God, please rescue me from the spirit of laziness. Refuse to be lazy. Refuse to be lazy. Find something to do. Find something to do. Refuse to be idle. Because nobody was created to stay at home doing nothing. A woman was not created to stay at home doing nothing. A woman was created to help the man fulfill his assignment. Kama wewe umeolewa na wewe ni housewife, hata unaringaga ukisema ama housewife. Haukuumba ukae tu nyumbani ufanye ukae tu chini, ugoje mzee akutumie pesa ya mvi. Hapana, enda usome Proverbs 31. Utaona mwanamke hapo ambaye a virtuous woman. Kazi yake anamkaga hata mbele ya Bwana. Kuna wanawake ambao ni lazy sana. Sijui kama wanawake watanisamehe. Wanawake mtanisamehe. Sio nyinyi. Tunaongea kuhusu hao. Si ni kweli eh? Praise the Lord. Kuna wanawake ambao ni very lazy. Wawezi kuamka. Wawezi kuamka mapema. Apikie mzee chakula asubuhi. Hawezi kuamka mapema. Apelekee mzee maji kwa bafu. Especially wasichana wa siku hizi ambao wako na kucha zinafika hapa. Hawezi kwenda kitchen. Anaoda chakula, anaoda pizza. Kila siku ni pizza. Sasa katambi mzee imefika huko. Kwa sababu kila siku ni pizza ama fries. Ama chipo. Hallelujah. Akipita pita huko anakuja na mtura na wanapika kaugali, wanasonga kaugali hapo haraka haraka dakika 5, alafu anasonga ugali, alafu ako kwa laptop, anasonga ugali ako kwa laptop. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. Mungu atusaidie sana. Angalia kucha za jirani yako, umwambie hata sisi tunakuja. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. Hawezi kwenda bafu akafua nguo. Hawezi kufua nguo. Amesumbua bwana anunue washing machine. Iletwe kwa nyumba ioshe, na pia kuna dishwasher. Hawezi kufanya kazi yoyote. Kazi yake ni anashindaka tu hivi. Sio mira nakula, anashindaka hivi akitengeneza kucha. Akitengeneza kucha na kujiangalia kwa kio na kujipodoa. Siku mzima in the house. Alafu anajipiga selfie, alafu anatuma kwa Facebook. No wonder kwa hiyo nyumba akukosi vita kila siku. Kila siku lazima mzee apigane, kwa sababu mama akona watu wengi sana ambao wanamwadamaya. Mungu akusaidie sana. Hiyo pepo ikufe leo katika jina la Yesu. Nasema hiyo pepo ikufe leo katika jina la Yesu. Hallelujah. Na nyinyi wazee, nanyi mwamke mwende kazi. Mwamke mwende kazi, mfanye kazi. Mwanaume ni kujitafutia. Mwanaume ni kutafutia bibi. Mwanaume ni kutafutia watoto. Hallelujah. Siku hizi tuko na bahati, tuko na wasichana na mabibi ambao wamesoma. Hallelujah. Lakini hata bibi akisoma, hakuna pesa tamu kama pesa ya mwanaume. Si ni kweli wadada? Hakuna pesa tamu kama pesa ya bwana yako. Kwa hivyo hata kama bibi yako na pesa mingi, ziwekwe kwa account, zifanye kazi zingine, muinvest in the future. Lakini nywele, ujue nywele ni pesa ngapi? Ujue rinda ni pesa ngapi? Hallelujah. Tulichallengewa sana na mheshimiwa Kamango aliposema kwamba yeye alikuwa anajua hata size ya sindiria ya mke wake. Hallelujah. Wazee mlio hapa, sijui tuko wangapi hapa, Mungu atusaidie sana. Na wale ambao wanaelekea kuwa wazee, Mungu awasaidie sana. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So you were not created to be idle. Even a woman was not created to be idle, to stay at home. You must make sure that you are contributing into the growth of your family. Contribute into the growth of your family. Ndio maana unapigwa kama mtu ambaye si wa maana, kwa sababu kila kitu kwa hiyo nyumba ni mzee alileta. Na akileta, wewe kazi yako ni kuharibu. Kazi yako ni kuua. Unajua kuna wanawake ambao ni wachafu, ambao ni wa... Mungu atuwasaidie sana wanawake. Na munisamehe leo. Sijui kwa nini nawaingilia hivyo, lakini ni Mungu tu anataka kutusaidia. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Kuna nyumba ukiingia utapata wadudu wengi sana. Unapata wadudu wa fly kila mahali. Hata mzee hawezi akakula kwa nyumba. Anakulaga kwa hoteli. Kwa sababu chakula ya hoteli imewekwa mahali pazuri, pananukia vizuri. You know, mahali pazuri, pananukia vizuri. Kwa nyumba, dirisha zifunguliagwi. Kumejaa harufu ingine hapo. Harufu ya uchafu ya mtoto kutoka asubuhi, bado iko kwa nyumba saa 4 usiku, na bado unataka bwana yako akukiss. Hata kukiss namna gani? Maziwa imejaa kwa nguo kila mahali. Mtoto alinyonya mpaka akakupiga na alafu bado unataka kiss. Mungu akusaidie sana. Na bado unasema ati wa Nigeria wako romantic. Hata wakikuyu ni romantic. Wajaluo ni wa romantic sana. Hallelujah. Wakamba ni wa romantic sana. Ni wewe ujatengeneza environment. Ambia jirani tengeneza environment. Yes. Mwanaume ameshinda huko kwa ofisi. Akiona lips zenye zinamuita. Kuja. Lips zenye zinamuita kuja unikisi. Alafu na wewe umekaa tu hivyo ndee kwa nyumba, hujajitengeneza, hata uwezi kupaka mafuta ya Vaseline. Hata kama hakuna Vaseline, si upake hiyo ya kupika, upake lips zako, hata lips zako zimu. Alafu unakuja hapa kwa pasta, ati pasta bwana yangu hata juagi nimebeba nini, kuna watoto hapa, Mungu atusaidie sana. Hallelujah. Pasta, hata bwana yangu ajuagi kama kuna kitu nimebeba. Hata juaji kama hujatengeneza environment. Ambia jirani tengeneza environment. Yes. Yes, your husband is very romantic. Anaweza kukuletea maua ukitengeneza environment. Lakini usipotengeneza utakuwa tu unaiona kwa Alejandro kwa TV. Hallelujah. Utakuwa tu unaionaga tu kwa TV. Mungu atusaidie sana. Hallelujah. Don't be lazy. Look at a neighbor and tell them, don't be lazy. Yes. Usikuwe lazy hata kwa nyumba. Usikuwe lazy hata kwa mwili wako. Enda salon. Utengeneze nywele. Nywele isikae hapo miezi tatu. Na bado unataka bwana yako aiguzaguze hivi mkiwa mmelala. Ataguza nini? Ataangalia huko. Ataangalia south ukiwa north. Hata atakupiga mateke utoke kwa hiyo kitanda. Hallelujah. Mungu akusaidie sana. Hallelujah. Inua mkono useme, my God, my Father, I rebuke the spirit of laziness. Say, I refuse to be lazy. Number four, whatever you find to do, do it with all your heart. Do it with all your heart. Do it with all your heart. Whatever you find to do, kama umepata kazi, ifanye na moyo wako wote. Usikue 50-50. Umeajiriwa kazi na bado unaweza kuangalia manager wako. Unaweza kuangalia your supervisor na umwambie, kwanza mimi hata siko hapa kukaa. Mkitaka kunivuta simunivute. You will lack favor. What are you lacking? What are you losing? Yes, you're losing favor without knowing. So whatever you do, do it with all your heart. Do it with all your heart. Colossians chapter 3 verse 23, the Bible says, give us from NIV, Colossians chapter 3. Nilisema leo watoto na wataka kwa Sunday school wote, ashes, tafadhali, watoto wote waende Sunday school. Na yule atakataa kwenda umfunye, mama yake akikuangalia vibaya, umuombe. Watoto wote tafadhali wapelekwe Sunday school. It's very, very important. Whatever you find to do, do it with all your heart. The Bible says, whatever you do, work at it with all your heart. As working for the Lord and not for men. Whatever you do, work at it with all your heart. Give us Ecclesiastes chapter 9 and verse 10. Ecclesiastes chapter 9 and verse 10. You cannot give your whole heart into something and not master it. You cannot give your whole heart into something and not master it. Let me say this. You cannot be so good in something and not enjoy it. Let me say that again. You cannot be so good into something and not enjoy it. Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. So stop telling us that my heart is not there. That, you know, at mimi, grace yangu imeisha. Grace imeisha wapi? Grace bado iko. Give your heart to that work. And you will finally begin to enjoy it. You enjoy what you value. You only enjoy what you value. And whatever you pay a lot of price, anything that you invest into so much, you will discover that you will finally begin to value it. Anywhere you invest so much, that is what you are going actually to love the most. The Bible says that where your treasure is, that is where your heart will be. Praise the Lord. Where your heart is, where your treasure is where your heart will be. Hallelujah. Niwaongeleshe. Leo niwaongeleshe. Sema niko ready kuongeleshwa. Yes. Yes. So put your heart into something and you will find yourself loving it. You will find yourself loving it and enjoying it. But if you don't put your heart there, you will never love it. The reason you don't love your wife is because you chat with every other girl in church. But you don't chat with your wife. You don't chat. You don't invest in your wife. Ukipata mshahara, kama kuna kanguo kazuri utanunulia mtu, it's not your wife. It's somebody else. That is why you don't love your wife. Had you invested so much in your wife, you will love her. Because utaona hata kumuacha ni hasara. Hallelujah. Am I talking to somebody here? Lift up your hand and say, my Father, my God, give me the grace. Give me the grace to love my work. To love my work. Yes, love your work. Love your work. Love your work. Hallelujah. If you are so good into doing something, you will enjoy it. So stop saying that, Pastor, mimi huata si enjoy. Pastor, mimi huata si enjoy. Mimi hata nakuwaga mbali sana. Mimi nasemaga ukimaliza uniambie. Ukinimaliza uniite. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Ambia jirani, it's because you are not so good in it. You have not invested so much in it. Hallelujah. Hizo ndizo vitu zimeua familia kanisani. Mungu atusaidie sana. Leo ukienda, ukue very good at it. Ambia mzee karibu na wewe. Na kama wewe ni kijana ni kusikia ukiongea, unyamaze kabisa. Utuulize hii maswali after 10 years. Hallelujah. Ukienda nyumbani leo ukue very good at it. And then you begin to enjoy it. All of a sudden a miracle will happen. And you will begin to enjoy. May the Lord give you understanding in Jesus' mighty name. Whatever you find to do, do how? With all your heart. Put your heart there. Put your heart there. If you are employed, put your heart there. You are not, your heart is not there. Kama saa kumi kifika tayari umechukua handbag. Umeanza kufikiria kwenda. Tayari umeanza kupigia watu simu. Tukutane pale Freetown. Na ni saa kumi. Your heart is not there. And God is not blind. Look at your neighbor and tell them God can see in the secret. Yes, the director may not see. God will see. God will see. And the day of rewarding people, you will not be among the number. I pray that people from Dominion Center will be different. You will become a good worker. You will become a good employee. Look at 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 6, NLT. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 6, NLT. Inasema hivi. And hardworking farmers should be the first to enjoy the fruit of their labor. So if you are employed, make sure that you work with all your heart. If you are in business, make sure that you do it very well. If you are in ministry like me, make sure that you do it very well. Whatever you are doing, do it very well. Very well. Very well. Effects of laziness. Very fast as we close. Effects of laziness. Number one, laziness produces a painful and a tearful life. Laziness anywhere will produce a painful and a tearful life. A painful and a tearful life. A lazy person will never have a reason to be happy or enjoy his life. Even when he wants to be happy, there is nothing to make him happy because he is lazy. There is nothing to make him happy because he doesn't have anything. He doesn't have anything. That is why he will live in pain and in tears forever. Proverbs 15, verse 19. Give us from NIV. We read this together very fast. Proverbs 15, verse 19. From NIV, the Bible says, the way of the sluggard. Do you have Proverbs 15, 19? The way of the sluggard is blocked with the thorns, but the path of the upright is a highway. The way of the sluggard is blocked with thorns. So some of us, we are not struggling because of the devil. The devil has not closed any door. The devil is not working against you. The problem is laziness. The sluggard is blocked. The way of the sluggard. Sluggard hapo ni mtu mwenye mvivu, mtu hafifu, mtu mnyonge, mtu muzembe, mtu ambaye apendi kazi. Huyo mtu ndio Biblia inasema ya kwamba njia yake itakuwa imejaa miba, atafungiwa na miba. Akitaka kwenda hivi, anafungiwa na miba. Akitaka kununua shamba, anafungiwa na miba. Anything he wants to do, akitaka kuoa, kuna miba mingi sana imemzuia. Kwa sababu yeye ni lazy. Hiyo barabara ajui kujitengenezea njia. So barabara yake imejaa miba. Kwa sababu hawezi amka achukue panga aende akatakate miba. The way of the lazy person is blocked with thorns. Milango ngapi umejifungia kwa sababu ya uzembe? Uliajiriwa kazi hapo, ukashindwa. Baada ya 2 weeks wakakuvuta kazi, ukawaongelesha vibaya na wao wakakuvuta kazi. Ukakuja umechelewa, ulipoulizwa ukaongea vibaya kwa sababu wewe ni mzembe, ukavutwa kazi. Ukaenda mahali pengine, you know, ukaambiwa kazi inafaa kufanywa hivi. Hii taa inafaa kumulika huku kila wakati. Alafu wewe kwa sababu ya uzembe unaiweka tu vile unataka, unaimulikisha pande ile, ukiulizwa unafura, unajifungia huo mlango tena. Barabara ya mtu mvivu imejaa miba. Kila wakati ni kudungwa, kila wakati ni uchungu, kila wakati ni machozi. Hiyo haitakuwa sehemu yako. Nasema hiyo haitakuwa sehemu yako. Oh, nasema hiyo haitakuwa sehemu yako. But the path of a righteous man is a highway. Mtu ambaye amesikia Mungu na akatii Mungu, njia yake inakuwaga super highway. Akioa ni super highway. Watu wote wanamsupport. Akifungua biashara, super highway. Kwa sababu yeye sio mvivu. Alisikia neno aliyohubiriwa na mchungaji wake. Mungu, naomba kwamba siku ya leo atakuondolea roho ya uvivu katika jina la Yesu. A lazy person says life is short and everything will pass. So why bother? Why bother? That's the language of a lazy person. Life is short and everything will pass. Why bother? Yes. Life is short and everything will pass. But why can't everything pass by your children? Why can't good cars pass by your children? Why can't good education pass by your children? Why can't good things, good suits pass by your body? Why can't good money pass by your account? Everything is passing, yes. But God has not said that we should not enjoy. Today, from today, you will enjoy life. You will enjoy what God has provided. I say you will enjoy what God has provided. Good cars will pass by you. Good money will come to you. Good houses will come to you. Good education will come to you. But you cannot be lazy. Number two, laziness is the mother of poverty and struggle in life. Proverbs 12:24. Good news. Please listen to this word. This word will deliver you. This word will bring money to your pocket. This word, if you follow it, if you don't follow it, you can say it was not anointed. But if you follow it, you will know it was very much anointed. Because it will bring results in your life. Laziness is the mother of poverty and struggle in life. Proverbs 12:24, the Bible says, hard work will give you power. Look at your neighbor. Tell them, look at that word very well. Ambia jirani, look at that scripture very well. Hallelujah. Yes. Hard work will give you what? Power. Somebody say power. Wangapi wanataka power? Hard work will give you power. Power in ministry, power at work, power in the career, power in education, power in politics, power. Somebody say power. It is hard work that will give you power, but being lazy will make you a slave. Somebody say, I refuse to be a slave. Oh, say again, I refuse to be a slave. So a lazy person will never occupy any seat of greatness. Lazy people don't occupy seats of greatness. The first sign that a person will be poor is laziness. If you want to know somebody that is going to become very poor, look at how lazy they are. If they are lazy, they stay at home, they sit at one place, wakienda kazini ni kushinda wamelala the whole day. Wakiona boss ni wanasimama, wanaanza kujifanya walikuwa wanafanya kazi. They are lazy. Wakipatiwa kazi kidogo, lazima supervisor ashinde hapo akiwafuata. Supervisor akiondoka tu hivi kidogo, wanaanza stories. That person will end up a very lazy person. A very lazy person. Somebody say, not me. Oh, say again like you are prophesying. Say, not me. Number three. So a Christian who refuses to work will live a very painful and poor life, even if you're a Christian. Look at Proverbs before we go to number three. Look at Proverbs 12, verse 27. Good news. Proverbs 12, verse 27. As we round off. Oh, somebody say, I refuse to be lazy. Oh, you are the mighty God, the great I am. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, you are the mighty God, the great I am. Hallelujah. If you are lazy, you will never get what you are after. But if you work hard, you will get a fortune. May the Lord give you the spirit of activeness. May the Lord help you to be very active and to love your work. Number three, the spirit of laziness imprisons a person in the land of lack. The land of lack. The spirit of laziness imprisons a person in the land of lack. There are people who believe if people are making it, it's because of luck. It is not because of luck. It is because of hard work. It is not luck, it is work. Write down somewhere. People don't become rich by luck. People get rich by work. People don't become rich by luck. People get rich by work. Being lazy will make you poor, but hard work will make you rich. Proverbs 10 verse 4. Proverbs 10 verse 4. Being lazy will make you poor, but hard work will make you rich. So don't wait for luck. Don't wait for money to rain from heaven. People don't become rich because money came from heaven. Nobody will pray for you to become a millionaire. You will have to wake up and go to work. You will have to wake up and actually go to work. Otherwise, you can remain poor forever. I pray that none of us here will be poor. None of us here will remain poor, because we are receiving the grace to go to work. Simama kwa miguu yako bila uzembe na uombe hii maombi bila uzembe. Uambie Mungu, nimekataa kuwa mzembe. Nimekataa kuwa mzembe.